Okay, so today I'm going to be demonstrating Mrs. Sauer's sweet cornbread. As always, I have my hair up, I have my apron on, I've washed my hands, I have all my equipment out, and I have all my ingredients out too. So there's the bell, I'm doing this in school. Okay, so it first calls for 3/4 cup of flour. So to measure flour, you're either going to use a 1/2 cup and a 1/4 cup, or 1/4 cup 3 times. So I'm going to use the 1/2 cup. In the 1/4 cup, I have a leveler available, and of course I have my spoon available too. So remember, you're always going to lightly spoon. I could spoon over the flour bin, or I could do it over the wax paper. I'm going to choose to do it over the bin. So first I'm going to start with my 1/2 cup. I'm going to heap it over. You're going to level it off. You never use a leveler like this. You're always going to lift it up like this. I heap it over and then level off. You want to have a big enough piece of wax paper for your flour. I then have my 1/4 cup. Again, I'm going to heap it over and I'm going to level it off. So remember, cornbread is a type of quick bread. I'm then going to place my measured ingredients over to the side, and then I'm going to put all my ingredients back to me to give me more space. So remember, everybody's measuring something at the same time. So next I'm gonna grab my cornmeal. Cornmeal is a shared ingredient, so that will always be found on the sewing, on the cooking supply table. It's the same table I use for the sewing supplies too though. Okay, remember, I'm a one woman show here, so I can't stop and edit this as I go. So if I make a mistake, I make a mistake. So next is 1 cup of cornmeal. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm going to lightly spoon it, I'm going to heap it over, and I'm going to level it off. So this one I'm actually going to take out because I'm having difficulty getting my hand in the container. So again though, I have 2 pieces of wax paper. One, that extra cornmeal is being heaped over on, and then another one for my measured ingredients. So again, I heaped it over. I'm going to level it off. I have another big piece of wax paper to place my measured ingredient on. I'm going to take the extra and put it back into the container. When you're done with a shared ingredient, you should always put it back on the supply table. Next is 2/3 cup of white sugar. I'm just going to flip this over and use it, so which is regular granulated sugar. So to measure 2/3, I would use 1/3 cup 2 times. So I have 1 piece of wax paper, and then I want another piece of wax paper. So I noticed that I do have some chunks of sugar in my bin, so I'm just going to mash those up and get rid of those. Okay, so with the sugar, I can actually put it in, heap it over, and level it off again. Okay, so that's 1/3 cup. Gonna do the same thing, heap it over, level it off, and that's 2/3 cup. Again, when you're done with an ingredient, put it away if you're not going to need it again. All right, so I'm gonna get rid of this piece of wax paper now. I'm going to pop it in my garbage. That is over to the side. Okay, next is 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. So I have some smaller pieces of wax paper that are also already cut. So this time I'm going to be using my measuring spoon. You're going to pop it in to your baking soda. Remember, baking soda and baking powder are called leavening agents, and that's what's going to make your baked product rise. So again, you're going to heap it over, you're going to level it off. Here's my measured amount. I'm going to put it over to the side. And then I have my extra that I'm going to put back in my container, and I'm going to move that out of my way again. So, and then we have 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Again, I have 2 pieces of wax paper, one to level over, and then another one to put the measured ingredients on, okay? So with the salt, try not to go too much over, because in the extra we usually toss in the garbage, okay? Salt is pretty cheap. You can try to get it back into here without making a mess, or you can toss it in the garbage, okay? I'm just gonna put this off to my side. Next is the sour cream. Remember, you're not going to taste the sour cream in your recipe. Sour cream is going to make it really, really tender, right? And it's going to make it moist. So this calls for a half cup of sour cream. So this is another shared ingredient. Okay, you're going to use your rubber scraper for this. I'm actually going to cut another piece of wax paper, place this on because it can get messy. I'm not taking the sour cream out of the measuring cup. You're going to leave it in the measuring cup. Remember, you're always going to have two levelers, two sets of measuring cups also, and two sets of measuring spoons. That way you're not waiting for an ingredient. So I'm going to take my rubber scraper. I'm going to actually do this on top of the wax paper. You're going to use your rubber scraper because it's flexible and bendable. You're going to fill it all the way to the top. Your leveler actually has, I mean your rubber scraper or your rubber spatula actually has a straight edge on it. So I'm going to then go back and get the extra. I'm going to level it off. A little bit extra is not a big deal, okay? Then I'm just going to leave the rubber spatula right on the sour cream because when I put it all together, you're going to take it out with the rubber scraper or spatula too. Okay, so next is 1 cup of buttermilk. Okay, buttermilk is going to be used in your liquid measuring cup, and as always, you're going to level off. I mean, you're not going to level off, sorry. You're going to use a liquid measuring cup. You're always going to measure at eye level and on a flat surface. So this is eye level, but it's not a flat surface. So I'm going to bend down. I'm going to get to that 1 cup. This is also going to make it really moist. 1 cup of buttermilk. Okay, so I used to have a different recipe, and then I changed it up because Miss DeSena and I did not care for it. It was a little crumbly, so I tweaked it a little bit. I did a recipe a few times, and then I made it Mrs. Sour's sweet cornbread because you know I like things sweet and not sour like my name. Ha ha. All right, so we have the 1 stick of butter, which is a half cup. I've already melted this. In class, I will also melt this for you and have it available on the demo table. In the past, my students have made it go all over in the microwave, so I just put it in the microwave and you'll take it off the supply table. Okay, so at this point, I have all my ingredients, except for I skipped my 2 eggs. I've noticed I have not cracked my 2 eggs, so 2 separate custard bowls for your egg, so you can crack it on the table, you could crack it on the side. You're gonna make sure no shell or blood is in there. I'm gonna just pop it in here for now. I'll take the other one and crack that in my separate custard bowl, okay? And now I have, whoops, all my ingredients measured out. All right, so at this point, you would have me check your ingredients. And then you will move on to your directions. And I'm going to move on to that in 1 moment. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to go on with my directions. My oven is already preheated at 400 degrees. I'm going to do direction number 2, which is to lightly grease and flour your 8x8-inch pan. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a pan on the supply table with a little bit of butter. You'll have to grab a paper towel. Your butter should be nice and soft. Okay, you're going to take a small amount. You're going to rub it all over on the bottom. You're going to rub it all over on the sides. You shouldn't see big chunks of the butter. So this is very important that this is done properly because you're not going to be here to take the cornbread out of the oven. Okay, so it'll continue to cook. I will be responsible for letting it cool about 20 minutes and then taking it out. So your job is to lightly grease it. So I've gotten around all those corners of the sides. And then I need a little bit of flour. I'm going to take a little bit of flour, sprinkle it. I'm going to take my pan and I'm going to tap it all around. Beautiful. I'm going to take any extra flour or excess flour and tap it in the garbage. So I have to walk over to the garbage can. You're not going to hit the garbage can because the garbage can is dirty. All right, you're going to just tap it over it. You can use your table in class, tap it on the side. So now I've greased and floured and your pan is prepared for your batter. So direction number three, in a large bowl, so two people will be doing this at the same time. So one person will be doing the large bowl, one person will be doing the medium bowl. Again, I'm one woman, so I'm gonna be doing both. So it says in a large bowl, basically you're combining all your dry ingredients, the flour, the cornmeal, the sugar, and the baking soda. So I'm gonna take my flour, my cornmeal, my sugar. Just found a mistake on my direction. Oh no, I just read it improperly. The sugar, my baking soda, and my salt. And it says make a well in the center. So making a well is just forming a hole in the center. I'm looking for my wooden spoon. I know I had a wooden spoon out. I don't know what. Oh, my wooden spoon is on the floor. So I'm going to grab another wooden spoon. Voila. Okay. So it says to make a well. So I'm first going to combine. It said to combine, which means to stir all those dry ingredients together. Should take about 30 seconds. Looks like I saw something in there that maybe shouldn't have been in there. Stir that all up. Make that well in the center. Just form a hole in the middle. Somebody else should be doing in a medium mixing bowl. So in a medium mixing bowl, I'm going to whisk the eggs and buttermilk. So first says to mix the eggs. Those are my eggs. And my buttermilk. Remember, eye level on a flat surface. You're going to bend down. Gonna mix that all together. It's gonna kind of look like scrambled eggs. What I like to do is hold on to the bowl with my left hand because I'm a righty. And then use this whisk to break those eggs apart and combine that all together. Once you've done this, the next portion of direction number four says to add your melted butter. Here's my melted butter. Make sure I get all of that. And my sour cream. So remember, you should have kept your rubber scraper on your sour cream. I'm gonna use that rubber scraper and lift all of that out. Make sure you get it all because this is what's gonna make your cornbread nice and tender. All right, then I'm just gonna put that back on the wax paper. I'm gonna slowly start this and I'm gonna break that sour cream up. And this is gonna get nice and creamy. You're gonna notice that your butter kind of sticks to the side. So use those muscles and just whisk that all together. Okay, and the next direction is going to be to putting your dry and your liquid ingredients together. Remember, that's one of the most important parts of mixing quick breads, okay, is properly mixing your dry and liquid ingredients. You do not want to overmix because that can form tunnels and holes in your baked product, and it could also make it tough. Okay, so the person who's doing the liquid is going to take a little bit longer. So this is nice and smooth at this point. My next direction says to add my ingredients from my medium bowl, which is a liquid, into my dry ingredients, into the large bowl. And then it says to mix using a rubber scraper. So I like to use the rubber scraper. You don't have to clean this. It has a sour cream. You're using sour cream, so that's fine. Get all that extra batter. And this is where you don't want to overmix. You're slowly going to toss and mix this together. Use the rubber scraper and scrape the sides as you go. It's very slowly. We call it folding in. You take it from the middle and you lift it up. Again, it may be hard for you to see on video, but you don't want to take and stir it, okay, like you're using a wooden spoon. You're very slowly taking it and tossing it. So I'll know just by looking at your cornbread if you've overmixed. Okay, so you want to do it very slowly. You want to make sure all those dry ingredients underneath, I'm lifting it up. I still see some dry ingredients. I'm going to take it through the middle. Still seeing some dry. Lift it through the middle and toss it. Okay, so I'm good at this point. At this point, I'm gonna take my pan, my prepared pan, and then I'm gonna pour. If you want help with this, you can add, ooh, so I just saw that there was some more dry ingredients on the bottom. And now I'm gonna take and pour this. I do it in the middle, that way all the batter gets in the middle. You're gonna scrape, so see what I'm doing? Scraping all of that in, all that extra batter. Beautiful. You shouldn't have to. Anything else at this point, I'm gonna take, tap my pan. Okay, I'm gonna put oven mitts on and I'm gonna put it in the oven. It says about 20 to 25 minutes. So I put it for 18 minutes. If it overcooks, there's nothing you can do it overcooks. If you undercook it, you can always add more time. Okay, so I'm gonna stop the video, I'm gonna cook it, and then I'm gonna show you what the end result looks like. Okay, so I just took the cornbread out of the oven. It took about 24 minutes, so I put it for 18 minutes and I added a couple more minutes. I then tested it. I didn't have a toothpick available, so I took a knife, and what you do is you poke it through the middle and you want whatever you're poking in there to come out clean, okay? If it's wet, you would add a couple more minutes. What I also like to do, so you should have some cracks all up on the top. You could also make this cornbread into muffins too. I like to just take the knife and go all around. I actually must have did a really good job greasing and flouring it, because nothing is stuck on the side and it's already pulled away from the side of the pan, and that's a characteristic that it should do too. So next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wait about 20 minutes. So a quick bread should cool in the pan for about 20 minutes, okay? So in about 20 minutes, I'm gonna invert it and show you if I did do a good job greasing and flouring, and it should come out without it sticking to the bottom. What some people do is they take it out now and they're gonna notice that it's going to stick and it's gonna fall apart. So you wanna give it at least 20 minutes. So I'm gonna stop the video. In 20 minutes, I'm gonna come back and show you what it should look like. Okay, so my cornbread has cooled about 20 minutes. Now I'm gonna see how I did with greasing and flouring it. So like I said, I already took a knife all the way around. I'm gonna hope that I greased and floured it properly. Okay, so I'm gonna take, I'm gonna flip it, I'm gonna invert it, I'm gonna shake it, and look how beautiful it came out. I'm gonna take, nothing stuck, I greased and floured it. And then take it like this, and then I'm gonna continue to let it cool. I let it cool for about 2 hours throughout the school day, and then I wrap it up, all right? So I can't wait to taste this, Mrs. Sauer's sweet cornbread. I hope you enjoy, which is a quick bread.